In a clinical practicum course, providing feedback to a student is crucial to their success. This investigation will examine the five principles of positive feedback in supporting clinical teaching effectiveness. Joel Day is a second-year Bachelor of Nursing student at Humber College. He has completed the nursing labs for his course and is now doing his clinical placement at the Madison Long-Term Care Center. Mrs. Smith is a 90-year-old woman who has been admitted to the Madison Long-Term Care Center. She's hearing impaired and unable to stand without encouragement. Joel is expected to provide hygienic care and administer all of Mrs. Smith's medications. Michelle Wilson is a registered nurse and clinical teacher assigned to instruct Joel during his clinical placement. Her responsibility is to provide learning effectiveness through guidance and supportive, positive feedback.
Good morning, Joel. How are you?
Fine, Mrs. Wilson. How are you doing today?
Excellent. I think today what we'll do is we'll start by talking about your patients and the medication that you'll be giving.
Okay, my patient is Mrs. Smith, an elderly lady. So she's in here in the nursing home. She has some difficulty hearing. So I'll be giving her two medications. One is for her blood pressure, and then one for her fluids.
Can you tell me a little bit about these medications?
The blood pressure one, I've forgotten.
The first principle of feedback, providing specific and precise feedback. Effective feedback requires identifying specific needs and results. Be sure to clearly address the particular issue and offer an appropriate solution. General or vague feedback will not help the student target their obstacles. Remember to use encouraging language to reinforce positive behavior.
Okay, I think in order to give the medications more safely, what we should do is take the opportunity and just review the medications before we administer.
Okay, thank you. All right, Ms. Wilson, I'm ready to give the medications.
Excellent. Now, in your review, tell me a little bit about the medications you'll be giving today.
So for Mrs. Smith, I'm giving her two medications. Mm-hmm. One is called furosemide, which is a loop diuretic for reducing the amount of water in her body. And the second one is called ramipril, which is an antihypertensive for reducing her blood pressure.
Excellent. Now, when we're assessing for hydration status, what assessments are we going to use in order to look for that?
For hydration status, I would first of all look at her eyes. And then, forgotten.
Okay, no problem. That's great so far. But I think in order to give the medications more safely and more effectively, we'll take some time, do a little bit more review of the assessments, and when you're all done that, meet me back at the med cart. Oh, hey, Joel, how are you?
I'm okay.
Great. So, tell me what you've researched and what you've learned about fluid volume status assessment.
To assess the amount of volume in a person's body, I would first of all look at their skin to see if it's dry or moist. And then I'll be looking at their mucous membranes to check out their color. And mostly I would be looking at their urine.
Excellent.
Also, if available, I would be looking for the amount of fluid in their blood. This is called hematocrit.
The second principle of feedback, providing differing amounts of feedback and positive reinforcement. Providing recognition and support is important to increase self-confidence and ability. Initially, feedback and positive reinforcement should be provided frequently. However, as the program progresses, students should develop self-assessment skills and identify their own learning needs and areas for improvement.
Excellent. So I've seen you've done some great research. You're on the right track. Just continue to research your medications and assessments. And of course, I'm always here if you need any help. So let's get ready to prepare and give meds. This is what you'll be giving today. You'll be giving furosemide, 20 milligrams, PO, daily, and Ramipril, 5 milligrams PO daily. This MAR is a one-day MAR, so this is for 8 o'clock, and your Ramipril is also for 8, and then you'll initial here after we administer. Okay?
All right.
Joel approaches the medication cart and begins to prepare the medication for Mrs. Smith. Joel is confused as he rifles through the medicine without taking a moment to read the MAR. The third principle of feedback, providing verbal and visual feedback. When providing feedback, ensure that you offer verbal and visual cues to correct unproductive behavior. Explain where the errors or weakness in performance was located, and then show the correct process. After providing feedback, immediately follow up with an opportunity to allow the student to practice. By relating cognitive functions with physical movement, learners are able to better understand and connect concepts with physical actions.
One of the first things you should always remember for safety is when we're reviewing our checks to always have the MAR open, and you're going to do your first check. So we're going to make sure this is Mary Smith. We have the right drawer that says Mary Smith.
Mary Smith, yeah.
Okay, then pull out your drug. This is going to be our first check. We have furosemide, 20 milligrams, furosemide, 20 milligrams. Expiry date, June 25th, 2018. And PO, it's a tablet. Perfect. First check. Then we pull out our next medication. We have Ramipril, 5 milligrams. Ramipril, 5 milligrams. Expiry date, June 11th, 2020. And it's a pill, so PO. Now, before we pour anything, we do our second check. Okay? So, here we have our Ramipril, 5 milligrams PO daily. And furosemide, 20 milligrams PO daily. And everything has to match up. Yeah. Our third and final check, we take the medication, we take the MAR to the bedside, we make sure that we have the right patient with the right name band, then we can open up our medications, and that'll be our third and final check. So, it's all yours.
Okay, let's open up the MAR, look for the patient's name, Mary Smith.
Excellent.
Mary Smith, open it up. I look for furosemide, 20 milligrams. Furosemide, 20 milligrams. Expiry date 2020. That's good.
Perfect.
I look for Ramipril, 5 milligrams. Find Ramipril, 5 milligrams, 5 milligrams. It's a PO, orally, it's a tablet. Yes. Oh, and the expiry date? Yeah, it's not expired. And then I do another check. First one, furosemide. 20 milligrams, furosemide, 20 milligrams. Ramipril, 5 milligrams. Ramipril, 5 milligrams. Expiry date, good. Expiry date, it's good. Close it up. My two cups.
Okay, that'll be yours. Yeah. All right, let's go.
Hello, Mrs. Smith. My name is Joel. I'm a student nurse. That is my clinical instructor.
Hello.
Mrs. Wilson.
What have you got for me today?
Today I got medications for you, your blood pressure and your water pill. Before we give you medications, I have to measure your blood pressure to make sure it's fine. Okay, we are good. So your blood pressure is 140 over 90.
The fourth principle of feedback, providing prompt and timely feedback. It's important to immediately follow up with students when they are performing a technique inefficiently or incorrectly. Most feedback is time sensitive. The longer it takes to provide feedback, the less effective it is. Providing prompt feedback encourages students to immediately correct their behavior, enabling them to grow and learn.
So you can proceed with giving you the medication.
Are you forgetting something, Joel?
No, I've taken a blood pressure and it's 140 over 90.
One of the first things you always have to remember to decrease the risk of any errors is upon arriving into the room, make sure that you check the patient's name band against the name that's on the MAR. Always.
We're opening this up. Okay. So let me just double check again here. Mary Smith, Mary Smith. So which hand do you prefer using to swallow? This one? Okay. Put them in there.
Thank you.
Yeah. This is your water. All right, Mrs. Smith. That's it for today. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So before you go, Joel, can I just take a look at the MAR? Thank you. So I just want to ensure that anytime you give your medication, as soon as the patient takes the medication, you want to make sure that you sign them off. Okay? Oh. That's how everyone knows that the medication has been administered. And it just decreases any error. Okay? So I go ahead and sign those out now.
The fifth principle of feedback, providing diagnostic feedback. A key factor to providing effective feedback is to identify areas of improvement. Providing diagnostic feedback is a three-step process. Observe. Start by observing the student's performance and identify areas for improvement. Assess. Assess the student's performance and provide them with feedback on areas to work on. Act. The student will act on the feedback and improve their performance. Repeat the cycle until the performance has improved. This cycle of providing diagnostic feedback encourages reflective practice and skill development.
Great job today. I'd just like to sit down with you and just give you some feedback on how the day went while it's still fresh in our heads. Just go through some of the things that I observed today. So do you mind if we meet at about 1 o'clock or so?
Yes, I can do that.
All right, excellent. So I'll see you at 1 o'clock and we'll sit down and have a little talk.
Using these five principles, you are now prepared to solve your own cases and provide positive reinforcement and effective feedback. How would you provide feedback on the student's performance in this case? Perhaps begin by asking how they think they've performed. This practice encourages self-reflection and self-assessment, which are key components to their future role in the nursing profession. By establishing an open channel of communication and providing ongoing feedback, you will strengthen and support student learning in clinical practice.